Hello everyone. First of all, I would like to thank you for your interest in the course Develop Your Lighting and Rendering. In this lesson, we're going to be talking about how to set up your Maya and Katana softwares for project. So first, let's start with Maya. I'm currently using Autodesk Maya version 2020.4. It comes pre-installed with USD plugin. To activate the USD plugin, you have to go to Windows, Setting and Preferences, Plugin Manager. Once you have the plugin manager open, you have to first look up USD. That will give you a Maya USD plugin. After that, you can look up Maya to Hydra. That is mtoh.mll. So that's Maya to Hydra plugin. You'd need it for viewing your USD files in the viewport 2.0, but if you don't switch it on, that's fine. You won't be able to see the materials, but you can still transfer the objects in USD, so that's perfectly all right. Okay, then that's all you probably need to set up for Maya. Now, speaking about Katana, I have a batch script. So if I open the batch script here, you can see I have a default render for PRMan. That is Pixar Renderman plugin. You can get Pixar Renderman plugin as a non-commercial version to try out, experiment, and learn from it. It's available from renderman.pixar.com/store. So once you have that installed, you can use the bash script available with Katana and set it up in such a way that it references, first of all, the USD, and it references the Renderman. There is a full-fledged tutorial on how to set up USD for Katana. I'll link that in the bio, and also how to set up Renderman in case you don't want to use a bash script. You can also go to your environment variables in your Windows and set it up like that. But personally, I think the bash script makes a lot of sense because you can use the bash script available directly from Katana and just edit it to make it accessible for your project. Okay, so I'm using a bash script for Katana, which looks like this. What I'm basically doing is, I'm just modifying a few taglines which are already given through tutorials by Katana itself to activate USD plugin, as well as to set Renderman as my default rendering engine. Once you have your Katana set up, you can start working with USD. In order to check if you have correctly loaded the plugin, you can just type tab on the node graph and look up USD. If you can see USD in and other USD nodes using shading node, USD material bake, you have pretty much configured the USD plugin. To check up if you have Renderman as your renderer, you can go to render settings. Double click on it, so you'll get the parameters. And here you can see which renderer you are using. So my default is PRMan. Once you have all of this set up, you can also download the scene file, which is very kindly available at Renderman tutorial website. To download the scene file, go to learn in renderman.pixar.com/learn, and then you'll have to go to tutorials. Once you click on tutorials, you have multiple tutorials to learn the fundamentals for Renderman, and the course Renderman fundamentals is a really good start if you have no experience with Renderman at all. For our case, we'll go down and you can see the robot room available. Out here, you can download the project. I'll also link this in the description so it's easier for you to download it. It is available for free, and it is already textured for Maya using Renderman 22. But for now, we're going to export the scene from Maya to Katana using USD. If you just want to explore the scene, this is a really good tutorial already available on their website. It explains a lot of tricks and a lot of techniques really clearly. This tutorial was made by Leif Pedersen, who is already working at Pixar Renderman team. I've interacted with him on some of Renderman's lighting challenges, and it was really fun knowing him. I really appreciate his help with this tutorial. Thank you, Leif.